with five. She might ride or die. Never tell a lie. We like Bonnie Clyde. Looking at her thigh. Like, do it come with rice? She don't like FaceTime. She'll read a Skype. But I'm out for the night. Out for the night. Out for the night. Out for the night. Yeah, I'm out for the night. Out for the night. Out for the night. Out for the night.
Hey y'all, it's Kelsha. Welcome back to my channel. Y'all about to watch me slay this lace. No, I don't know how to do hair. No, I'm not a professional. But I hope y'all enjoy. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Keep watching.
Hey y'all, so I'm starting out with my stocking cap already on. I'm using like a light brown stocking cap and I'm cutting the ear holes out. I learned this from Hair by Erica J. It keeps the sides from rolling up when you cut the cap. So that's what you see me doing. And I got little ears, so don't judge me. They barely fit through the holes. And now I'm going in with my Got to Be Free spray just to lay the front of that cap down. And I'm like massaging that in, being careful not to let it drip down my forehead, because that's going to be my guideline for my glue, basically. So yeah, that's what you see me doing in this clip. And excuse my face, it was just cold as shit, so yeah. And then I'm just gonna blow dry that on cool, just to make sure it can get dry fast so I can go on about my business. The next part is self-explanatory, y'all, so yeah. This is Maybelline Fit Me. I'm just putting it all in. Usually I would just use a dark brown wig cap, but I didn't have one, so this is where I'm at with it. And then I'm just gonna take some scissors and go through and cut the excess cap off. And it should just lay down, seeing as how I did the little ear hole method and all that good stuff. But knowing me, I messed up. So my side over here that you see, my ear is not way out. It's gonna be messed up. Take y'all time when y'all cutting y'all cap off, just to make sure you cut off all that excess and all that, so that it can lay as flat to your head as possible. And then I'm just cutting the other side out. The other side laid so good, y'all. Oh my god, I'm so sad. See, look, and then look at this side. And I'm just going back in with some more foundation to blend those edges down. And then I went in with some 91% alcohol and cleaned up around my hairline again in front of that cap. So yeah. Here go my wig, sis. This is like a 14-inch deep wave wig. I already wore it before, hence the lace already being cut. So now all I gotta do is just reapply it. I'm just checking to see the blend, what it looked like, and it looked pretty good so far. I went through and cut off some of the extra lace, and I'm using a pencil to mark out where the wig lays so I can just use that as a guide for my glue. I'm using a ghost bond glue, and then I'm just putting dots of that around my hairline, and I slowed this portion down. Once you do that, you grab like a rat tail comb or something flat. I just use a pop-tip stick or a rat tail comb, and then you just smooth it down. But because you want it to be like flat, and I smoothed this back onto the cap to hold the cap down, and I only use two layers. So in the next clip, you'll see me repeating this process. The more layers you use, the longer your wig will last, but I don't really want mine to last that long, so I'm just using two layers. And then once it dries clear, you go in with the next layer. And then once that dries clear, you put your wig on. Can't wait to be back to back to back in the bizzles. No more being broken, it ain't no y'all see me repeating the process on this side again. And then I'm just making sure that dries down clear. And I'm sitting my wig right on top. I'm not pulling it. I'm just sitting it there. And then I'm just going to go section by section and sit the wig down. And then you'll see me just barely tap it in because I don't want to like mess it up. And then I also learned this from Hair by Erica J. I just go in and I comb the wig on, basically creating some tension, like combing it into the glue, so that none of the oils from my finger or anything actually get on the glue and turn it white. So I'm just like combing it in and pressing it down just gently with the tip of that rat tail comb. And I find this method helps melt it really, really good. I'm no professional, y'all, so I'm just doing how I learned how to do it or how I taught myself. So now the wig is applied, and then I'm just cutting off any excess lace and all that good stuff to clean it up. And then now I'm going to apply a headband to apply pressure to melt it down for a little bit. I blow dried it again, but I didn't show that portion. And then now I'm going into styling the wig. I wanted a center part, so that's what I did. I created a middle part and, you know, just went through with some hair wax so that I can like lay that hair down and hit it with a hot comb. And then now I'm just going in with my hot comb to give it like a really sleek flat appearance. Y'all, if y'all want y'all wigs to be flat, you need a hot comb. Like, it's no question about it. It transforms the wig. So I want to keep my curls, so I'm only flattening the roots of the wig so it won't be so puffy. And then I'm just finger detangling. I went in with some MAC Mineralized Skin Finish to take away that shiny look of the glue and just blend it in more with my hairline. And then I'm going in with some concealer straight down the part because I didn't want to pluck my part. So I just went in with some concealer and hit it with the hot comb again. And then now I'm done.
Oh, well, okay.
Oh.
Oh, hey, Lace Queen. Where you going?
To lunch and do. Say hey to my YouTube.
Hey.
Yeah, I'm going to Ferrero to get me some pizza.
Wait, I've been on YouTube this whole time?
Yeah, but I'm gonna mute that part.
Okay, cool.
This is so cute, y'all.